behind me. I run the drum. I love your games. I love your lies. I love your games. Look in my eyes. Take me in your arms and hold me tight just for tonight. I need no drugs, I love your lies. You hide me from the lights. You're lying, I'm buying. I'm buying every word. I love your lies. I love your games. Take me to the ballroom. You're dancing through the nights. I'm in your arms, I love your lies. They make me feel so nice. Lying to your shadow, snuck into my face. You're lying, I love it. You're lying, I love it. You're lying. From the very beginning on, we always were totally independent from any record company. It says in our contract that we don't have to talk about music or videos with any record company. We just deliver the finished product the way we do it ourselves. And it was indeed a big advantage that we kind of grew with our equipment. The first album was recorded just on a 4-track machine, then we had an 8-track machine, then we had a 16-track machine, and now of course we have a fairly big studio. But we truly grew with all this technology, which gives us the possibility to really play the studio like the bongos of the 20th century and not be played. We never became the slave of the machine. We never became dependent on A&R people or producers.
I was starting doing music or noises when I was very young. I had when I was about 14 or 15, a guitar which I really couldn't handle, 5 or even 6 strings together. It was too much for me, and control here, you have to play in fingers, you know, and then I put just 2 or 3 strings away and it was much easier to play. And even then I couldn't play really guitar, really sounds not that good. So I start pulling all the strings away and just turn the body, the acoustic body of the guitar around, and put a microphone inside the guitar and start drumming, and like I use it like a bongo. And at the same time, this was all at home, at my parents' places, or my parents' place. And I also tried to make out of a bamboo like a flute, and I started, it wasn't like a do re mi fa sol la di do, it just has some holes which I drill in it, and I start doing some strange noise with this flute, and I start recording this with a Revox tape with the echo and everything. This really fascinates me. So this was how I start doing music in a way. Later on I met Carlos Peron, we did this together and make some nice pieces. And then we met a guy in Zurich, this was our contact man in kind of music. He runs a record shop, and we always play the music to him, and he thought we do very nice music, but he thinks we need a singer, and he has an idea. He knows a nice singer, and the singer calls Dieter Meyer.
When he makes you up, the night began. Between the bottles and the mirror, I'm smiling at myself. Open my eyes and start to count the bottles on the shelf. Bottles on the shelf.
musician since he is 15. He always went his very own ways, and he would rather still be a truck driver again to survive than to make any compromises.
Very short before we met Dieter, and I was driving for a paper factory to with tracks. I'm driving with tracks, and I listened all what I have done the day before on a little cassette recorder, and I always had this on the side, on the other seat in this track. And I have a few accidents. And the last few accidents that are real total accidents, total damage. And one reason was, once I had the cassette deck in the car to listen what I'd done the day before, I always would like to check out what I'd done before. And I have to brake a little bit, and the cassette falls on the floor in the track, and I would like to pick it up on the floor, and suddenly I push in like four or five or even six other cars, like an accordion. I pushed them together, and yeah, this was the time when the boss of the company told me, Mr. Blank, the insurance wouldn't pay anymore. What shall we do? You can work probably in another place in our factory, but not driving anymore.
French, moment musical, which means it's sort of a certain scene, a certain mood, but not necessarily a message and a story that is clearly defined and goes from A to B. When I had my first exhibition in 71 in a museum here in Switzerland, a critic came and he interviewed me in front of one of my works, and he asked me, what do you want to say with this? And I said, if I could tell you better with words than with my work, I would be an idiot to do this work. Thank you. Circus, basically. The idea of joy and of entertainment is in the very center. And since we are selling a few records, it's like at the beginning the circus just had a donkey and a monkey and Boris and myself, and we had to do sort of everything with nothing. And now the circus grew, and whatever sort of money we make, we enjoy to have the circus look nicer. We are now maybe having elephants and crocodiles and trapeze artists and whatever, and it all contributes to the, yeah, call it, because like Mozart and Shakespeare, we're in show business, right? Let's call it the Yellow Show. I don't think we are any better than any stripper, basically. It's all show business. Whether it's interesting, whether it's art or something important, time will tell. But basically, we're all in show business, right? Of course, if you have found your kind of your style, your way of exposing yourself in this field, you're not changing this constantly, but very organically you grow within your style. If you're not a fake or a flake who is kind of adopting all kinds of things and just always putting on a new jacket again and holding the finger out of the window to watch where the wind is blowing from, then of course you are recognizable immediately as Yellow, and you also repeat yourself. You know, you cannot invent Yellow every day. It's part of the game that you slowly grow within the parameters of your style you have set. And this is why I don't want to compare myself with any of the great classical composers, of course, but why do you recognize, after having heard maybe three pieces of Mozart, you recognize Mozart, even a piece you have not heard? Because it's him, it's his style. He is kind of always the same.
I love you.
I know.
I love you.
I know.
You're gonna get me a heart attack. Stop it, hold it, hold it back.
I love you.
Yellow and for our music is that we felt, Boris and myself, from the very beginning on, that we are not standing in a tradition of rock and pop music. Switzerland is the deepest province for this. And to not stand in a tradition pushes you to do something on your own. Switzerland is a very small country, so when you create something, it's like, how should I say, it's like the inner escape, the escape in your spirit and in your brain is very important. This is especially the case for Boris, who is creating music that sometimes sounds from a totally different part of the world. People are asking us, are you influenced by Brazilian music or are you influenced by African music? And we have to say no. It's our dream of Africa. It's like traveling there, like a kid who has certain ideas of Africa, but without leaving Switzerland. We never listen to ethnological music and then sort of transfer this into Yello music.
I think everybody has their own cinemas in their brain. And I like to replace the ear, or I think physiologically you can say you also can see what you hear, or you can smell something and it reminds you a certain place where you have staying 20 years ago.
Optimists, and we enjoy fun and jokes and ironies. We're totally uncynical, and I think we found this little world where we are allowed to, coming back to the comparison I did before, to become like kids. And this is like a child. And this is, of course, a very optimistic process, because there's nothing more beautiful than a child. If you see Boris working in the studio, it's not the process of kind of a technician or of a producer or of an engineer who kind of is fiddling and knobbing and concentrating. He really plays this very complicated machinery like a little kid in the streets of Havana plays his little drum. Person who can sit for 10 hours in a room. It's not my thing. I like working in the studio, but my approach is a totally different one. I listen to what Boris has done. We talk about it maybe for 5 minutes and I leave again.
For example, the Otto Catania, Otto di Catania of our last album was just, yeah, the music without his voice, and he comes in. And he thought it would be very nice, a Fellini-like voice. And he did this in, like, he just writes some lyrics. Okay, yeah, Boris, okay, we go. And then he starts, and 10 minutes later, he left the studio, and it was already done. So it was a one-take shot, which is...
spettatori, amici del varietà, calorissimo pubblico, buonasera qui al Stellamatto. Nella prima parte del programma, venuto direttamente dal Cairo, la famosissima Lolita del Sudan, una danzatrice del vento, accompagnato, come sempre, della nostra orchestra Paolo Silvestri. Prego, maestro, a lei.
I would say I'm spending more or less every day in the studio. I'm working like a worker in the studio. And I'm not saying I'm working, because it's a hobby to do this. It's big fun, like a child or children playing with a choo-choo train. I'm playing now with these instruments and try to developing as much I can out of these instruments.
I love you.
Because we're so different, and we accept that everybody has his area. It's like Boris is my producer and I'm his producer. And this clear separation of what everybody does makes us a very good team, I think. I mean, if I had the same approach to the studio he has, and we would always sit together in the studio for 10 hours a day, I think we would have a lot of problems. The fact that we are so different, that I hate to sit in the studio for 10 hours and Boris loves it, makes it a perfect team, I think. In every aspect, we are very different.
Oh.
sometimes we have clashes when I think Boris is over perfect, when I think that things that he had recorded were much sort of fresher and spontaneous than at the end of a piece. And when he is my producer, when I'm singing, we sometimes have these arguments when I think I've done a very sort of fresh performance, maybe with some mistakes in it. I don't care for these mistakes, and I want him to leave it as it is. And he pushes me to a perfect, within my limits, of course, a perfect performance. And this always is kind of pushing me from a first spontaneous approach, which I enjoy, through the valley of boredom and having to do it again and again and again, and I totally lose touch to the song, and then slowly, slowly climb out of this valley up to a next hill where I hopefully see the sun again off the song. And always in this process, when I'm down in the valley after having done it maybe 150 times and it's still not right, I hate him. We love dance music. Sometimes people ask me in a pejorative way, well, how do you feel about being successful in discotheques, you know? And I always say I love it, because I think the first music on this planet was played to move to and not to sit in a chair and to listen to. So when people interpret your music by dancing, this is the biggest compliment for me. That's it. Okay. Okay, here's a very good example of... Stop it, Wolfgang. How we do our videos. We don't create reality. Very much like in the way we produce our music, where a balloon with a piece of wood being banged on it can be a bass. In our videos, a little spool of copper being turned around and lit with a blue light and filmed with a macro lens can become a waterfall if we project this little piece of reality onto a huge 10 by 20 meter front projection screen. This is actually very much the technique which I'm going to use in Snowball, this opera fairy tale feature film which I'm shooting this summer in Poland. And I could sum up the technique by saying it's all about l'image trouvée. You remember Marcel Duchamp, the great French artist, he was talking of the found object of l'objet trouvé, which means he just took a piece of reality, like a stand for beer glasses, and he put it onto the pedestal of art and said, this is my sculpture. And very much in the same tradition, we find pictures in a reality which we change totally for the use in our videos.
I don't see a tomb.
It's breathing. It's breathing.
Good day. Do you speak my language? I mean, where am I?
The chosen one is here.
The chosen one? Who's he? Open up!
Do you have an appointment?
Of course not.
Who the hell are you?
I'm the architect.
Let me see the little thing here again. This is a waterfall. And superimposed is a rose. It's all a montage in a 60mm camera, which we then project the film onto a huge screen to become a new reality in our videos.
You are my sun, all the strangers in time. Please call me later tonight, cause I'm waiting.
Time is gone, you'll never ever be alone.
You are my sun in the darkness of time.
The night is so long, you'll never ever be
just a band which sort of tries to make it in the rock industry. Yello is a way to live.
I think music could be young forever, or I can be young forever within music.
You left me.